bastards.
Hey, no name calling. You lost the Parcheesi tournament fair and square. Now, we've confiscated all the weapons, and we've left explicit instructions with the doctor that you are not to be killed. You've got your sobi, you've got your script. Have fun.
All the broken hearts in the world still be. Let's not make it harder than it has to be.
Hello, I'm Plutoburns, and welcome to Eagleland. What was it said in the last episode? One of these days, I'm really gonna have to get down to reviewing the rancid effluence that is the harem genre. Apparently, that's today!
Though, personally, I wouldn't even call this a harem. Yeah, it's got all the trappings of a harem with the bizarre cast of human aliens and a really stupid plot, but it also only has two girls vying for a guy's attention. That's not a harem, that's bigamy.
I think it's rather small of you to point that out.
Breaker, breaker, we got an errant pun maker. We need someone to come up here and deal with this.
Yes, yes, sir, you son of a bitch!
Thanks, Cap.
Cut you like a
Everybody gets
next
one.
Time you die.
So here's our hero, Derriere. It's hot. I want to spend time in my AC'd room with Marintan. Right, Marintan? Oh.
I would feel more comfortable making fun of this if not for the fact that a Japanese man actually did marry his virtual girlfriend. Thankfully, I can make fun of the fact that this character completely rips off another manga.
Yeah, Derriere is a pretty blatant ripoff of the hero from the world God only knows. Except with all his likability and quirks removed to be replaced with bland Gary Stewness. He even wears inexplicably designed glasses. God, it's like his glasses don't even exist.
Now I'm gonna introduce another character here, and it's just gonna keep going, so just bear with the stupid until it cuts back to me. Take it away, voiceover.
Hello, ladies and gents.
Haru-chan, you jerk!
Hotaru, don't interrupt my day with Marintan.
Haru-chan, why did you leave without me? I have no idea what I'll do if you ever hate me.
I don't hate you, I don't hate you.
Goody. Anyway, since your parents went overseas on a business trip, I made you lunch.
How did you know that my parents would be gone for the rest of the manga?
From a wiretap.
I don't think I can eat all of that.
Then I'll just have to personally pack it into your tummy.
Goddamn scissors. So, Crazy McKill-Kill here is a type of anime personality called Yandare. Yandares are sweet and lovable girlfriends until you suggest that maybe the relationship isn't working out, and then they go...
Silence! I kill you!
Yandare originated in the horror genre, and McKill-Kill's box cutter weapon is a reference to a classic Yandare character. And for reasons I do not fully grasp, anime fans have decided that Yandare is cute. So McKill-Kill here is one of our primary romantic interests.
Oh, but then we get introduced to Mion-senpai. She confuses me. Ostensibly, she's this super pervy mad scientist thing that wants to make the rest of the world as pervy as her, somewhat in the vein of the little sister from Happy World, but she just doesn't make sense in this world.
All the characters are various anime manga stereotypes, so that's not the problem. The problem is she's from a completely different kind of story. She belongs in a sci-fi or fantasy piece, not the ostensible reality of this story. She makes about as much sense here as Lelouch would make in One Piece.
Oh no! We're entering plot territory! Everyone brace yourselves!
You mean things are gonna start making sense?
So we go on a walking tour of the school, meeting characters who clearly won't be important later on. Then the overtly sexualized student president introduces this character!
So including Mr. Liar Game Wannabe, how many ripoff characters are we at now?
About four. Mr. Majora here is the... Minister's aide in charge of the declining birth rate countermeasures. He tells all the students that they will have to start dating, or he will explode them with nanomachines that were implanted during their vaccinations. Derriere asks if he can date Marintan, but Majora just shoots the phone. 1 month later, and all the students are paired off, except for these laggards.
So, here's an awkward question. Why go to all this trouble? I'm not referring to Mask Eye's plan or how much it must cost. This is clearly a manga where sense and logic were sacrificed at the altar of Kali.
Mukti Degi Kalima. Kalima. Kalima.
Comedy. I meant to say at the altar of comedy.
I'm talking to the author. If your whole intention was for these particular characters to be the focus, why not just have everyone in the school already be dating? And these ones were singled out as being deviants. Same result. With your version, there's about 200 people wandering around with bombs in them that will never be addressed ever again.
Oh, and for those of you that spotted the numbers issue immediately, congratulations, you know fractions.
Zoro sets them some date challenges that they all have to complete or be exploded. And that chapter opens with Derriere getting kicked in the face by sadistic president. Why? Because he spilled almost an entire cup of juice on Shota Bait and a tiny bit of it got on her shoe. She then proceeds to grind his hand beneath her foot until he agrees to lick her shoes clean.
And she is the other romantic interest for Punching Bag. And I know for a fact that this manga has fans who debate which of the two girls he should have gone with. So instead of a rock and a hard place, we have a psycho and a bitch.
So Derriere's mission is to get Sato to kiss him, and his brilliant plan for this is to play strip rock paper scissors with her. She wins a lot, but they both end up stripping down to their skivvies and, oh my god, this is so stupid. She kisses him out of pity, and of course, this is the catalyst moment for Sato to fall in love with him eventually, because of course, underneath that hard exterior, she's an innocent little butterfly of a girl just waiting to be set free by a man.
Was this written in the 90s? Because I really feel like it was written in the 90s. Dude, the 90s were totally not a period of reductive female writing. Doc, we told you not to revive that one.
My bad.
They all get knocked out and transported to a giant mansion on a private island, because the plot demands it. Also, fan service. Derriere,
I call him that because he's an ass,
finds a mysterious mask in his room with a letter. Next scene. Fat Boy tells Money Monster that she looks cute with her hair up. She blushes, indicating they shall become a couple. Next scene. Derriere is given the mission of getting a new couple together, and if he succeeds, he will be let out of the program. So he dons the thespian mask and pretends to be Majora while setting the other players a new mission, and what the shit is this?
The main character from the world God only knows was a dating sim master. He was really good at breaking down relationships into a system. So it made sense that when his life was on the line, he could leverage that skill into attracting real girls. When has Derriere ever indicated that he's a master actor and voice imitator? Even if I ignore the obvious height difference between the characters, just because you put on someone's mask does not mean you can perfectly imitate them. What do you mean I have to do the corner? Little Miss Muffet sat on a tuffet eating her... I don't know the rest.
So his mission of making a new couple within 3 hours is not well received. Shota Bait turns out to be the manipulative seducer character.
Usually that's a female. Progress?
Shota Bait seduces Ladies Man into doing something desperate. Meanwhile, Fat Boy turns out to be the most human character in this manga. But then he demonstrates hitherto unknown knowledge about Busty's fear of the dark. They become a couple, so now Derriere can finally get the hell out of this manga. But then Ladies Man attacks Derriere, thinking he can finally end this program. The reveal of Derriere's masquerade is met with shock and some relief, since he had to fake his own death to accomplish this scheme.
Another thing that I'm sure is easy to pull off without practice or skill.
Then Majora shows up via magical hologram. He declares that Ladies Man must die for daring to attack his stand-in. Derriere offers to rejoin the program in exchange for saving his life.
Really? You'll rejoin the program?
Yes.
All right. But he still has to die.
But you said...
I never agreed to that trade.
Yeah, he didn't. Dumbass. Okay, it's been argued to me that this is a parody of Bad Harems. I can see how you could make that argument, but even as a parody, this is not a good manga.
So Ladies Man runs outside and gets exploded, while Shotabate laughs maniacally like the friggin' Joker.
Wait, this wasn't in the script.
This is not a wacky parody. Your right to that title was revoked the moment you tried to have a serious and moving death scene with bad guys and stakes.
And the manga never recovers from this moment. It colors my acceptance of all the BS it tries to pull off from this point on. Introducing real-world death logic is not the kind of thing you can just call take-backs on. And I'm only about halfway through. This manga muddles on for another 13 chapters before finally throwing in the towel.
Now that it's been established that characters can die, you know what would be hilarious? A battle royale ripoff. Where the boys use rubber bullets and battle armor to defend the girls from... Oh my god, I can't believe I actually have to read this. A genetically engineered Amazonian lesbian super soldier who wants to beat up the guys and take all the girls for herself. After the introduction of a girl whose luck is so epically bad it warps space-time, the manga kinda just gives up. It just piddles around for a while, trying desperately to make me care whether Derriere will go out with Stabby McKillkill or Sado Bitch. I have seen fans of this get into arguments about which girl would be a better choice. Why do you care? These people are horrible!
Oh, Mr. Clark, am I the only one who hates those miserable little brats? You hate them too?
Skipping to the end, Shotabate takes his AI brain father hostage, using himself as the bomb, just go with it, while Derriere has to make the ultimate choice between the two nutcase girls. The other characters try to stop Shotabate for some reason, while Majora's Mask realizes his bosses are corrupt idiots. And oh no, the mountain man who never had a single word fell into a vat of poison and is injured. Hey, do your job.
No, I refuse to give a shit.
Derriere says he can't choose, so he just ends up dating both of them. And then they travel the world, because that's clearly something 15-year-olds are allowed to do unaccompanied. The end.
This manga really reminds me of one particular scene from Welcome to the NHK.
The two guys are working on the design document for a dating sim they want to make. Sato proposes this for the love interest character background.
I've got it! I think I finally have an idea for the heroine of our game!
Seriously?
She's your classmate and childhood friend who also happens to live next door. She's also a robot, but not just any robot, a maid robot!
And they just keep adding more and more cliched background traits to the character until finally she looks like this.
What the hell is this?
It's the heroine of our game, Sato. She's a sickly alien maid robot ghost childhood friend that's the reincarnation of a fox with a split personality. Well, there you have it. Now all that's left is to write a scenario for her.
That's this manga. It's just a bunch of tropes thrown into a pot, mixed together, and slopped out in front of you. and it's about as pleasant as touching the fresh gum underneath a restaurant table. I'm not telling you the author's name. He doesn't deserve the attention. I'm Plutoburns, and I'm out. I'm out!
Yes, I'd rather jump naked on a huge pile of thumbtacks. I'll stick my nostrils together with crazy glue. I'd rather dive into a swimming pool.